Hi guys, and welcome back. Here's I've got two pawpaw papaya here, and a taro there, and a coconut cream. I'm gonna make Niue, request my view. Niue Takihi. It's taro, and but I couldn't find a white taro, so I'm gonna just use a purple taro, pink taro. And here I've got little quails. Little birds, little quails, and I'm going to deep fry that and make a spicy sauce. And here's our fe'e, our octopus. I'm going to use our fe'e to put it in the oven, drain the water out, and then put in this coconut cream. That coconut cream. Okay, guys, the kara coconut cream. Okay, let's start cooking. It'll be easy and simple. And I'm going to do my idea of Niue favorite food. The traditional food is Takihi, yeah. Using pawpaw and taro and coconut cream. Hey guys, here I come back. Here's my tray. And I'm going to put our octopus in there. It's still a little bit frozen, but hey, that's good. Yeah, it's good. All good. So I'm going to do it with our octopus. See, they took the ink out. And I couldn't find a ink. I couldn't buy the ink. You know, they haven't got any. They say. Okay. Our octopus is just going to go in the oven. Just like this. Until it turns red and all the water is drained out of it. And then after that, we're cutting off. Then cut it up and put in coconut cream. A little bit of splash of white pepper. A little bit of salt, but not to worry about salt because it's already got a lot of, what do you call, full of salt. Okay, be back in a minute. Hey guys, here's our little quails. Already wash it. Little birds. And wash it nicely. And I'm going to marinate it very quick. Just a little mayonnaise to make it, you know, give it that flavor before I deep fry it. Bit of lemongrass. Lemongrass outside is still small because of the cold weather. Okay, lemongrass. Just giving the flavor before we get to fry them. Bit of ginger. Let's give it a nice flavor, guys. Just slice it small. And we've got some chili. Who's that beeping the horn? Some fresh chili from outside. Just cut it, slice it up small. This chili, you can find some is really hot, and you can find some is not hot at all. Here it goes, add it in a bowl. Okay, a little bit of pepper. A little bit of soy sauce. This is a mushroom soy sauce, thick one. It's a little bit. I don't want too much. Okay. A little bit of sesame seed oil. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit of fresh water. Okay, we need to mix them around. Giving all that flavor into it. I'll cover it with flat wrap until the time to deep fry. Okay guys, here's our little quails already marinated. Cover it up and ready to deep fry. I'll be back. Guys, we're burning our taro. Manukalo. Yeah. Okay, then I'll slice this up and peel up a pawpaw with a knife. Guys, I'm peeling our pawpaw. Just push your knife down and slide it through it. Some people call it pawpaw, some people call it papaya. And we call it in Samoa, Essie. And foot, you know. This is our pawpaw. Okay, I'm gonna build the other one and keep going. Hey guys, I'm gonna cut our pawpaw now. See how beautiful that pawpaw is. Beautiful. I'm gonna put these seeds in my garden and bury it, and hopefully, okay, I've got a really pawpaw growing outside. Hopefully, it will grow again in the winter. Get rid of the seeds. Well, look, you can get the end. Get the end of the pawpaw, and all the seeds come out of it. And then use a spoon for the one that sucks you in there. Really small. Slice it small. Okay. And I'm gonna try to cut it as small as I can. The smaller you cut it, the better it is to and quicker it is to cook with our pawpaw. There's about that length. I'm gonna cut it all up and set our thing. Like I said, I couldn't get the white taro. They got a frozen one. But we don't need a frozen one, you can't use it. Guys, I'm cutting the pawpaw. See? Cut it as thin as it can get. But maybe a little bit bigger than the taro. Because the pawpaw cook very quick and the taro takes time to cook. Just gonna use the back of this, cut it off thin. There. And keep cutting down, putting a foil in it so to make a shape. Okay, I'm gonna layer our food now. Our pawpaw, layers of pawpaw on the ground. Gonna put layer after layer of pawpaw. I should put a bit of coconut in there. Bit of oil, bit of coconut cream. So it doesn't burn. Okay. A layer of taros. Go the other way. Now keep going there, guys. Keep going until it's full. Layer pawpaw. Okay. I'm gonna add my own vision, guys. A little bit of light pepper and a bit of little salt on the pawpaw. Just a sprinkle of salt. Okay, my twist is a lemon zest, giving that acidity. I know this has never been done before, but I tell you guys, it's a different way. Make it your own way. We can follow the recipe. Oh, wait, having a cup of taro. Bit more coconut. More pawpaw. See, I'm laying the taro across the other way and the pawpaw across that way. Looks like I'm gonna have to cut some more pawpaw up. So I've still got a half a pawpaw they haven't cut. Okay guys, again, sprinkle of pepper, just light pepper, light salt, bit of lemon zest. Just a sprinkle, not too much. Just giving it as it tastes, the salt, the sweet from the pawpaw. Okay. Now turn again. Fingers crossed will come out good and yummy. Just like how the Niue do it. The only difference, I'm adding my own special treatment, like you can see the bit of pepper. Okay. I need more pawpaw. That's the last layer of char. Nice. And last layer of pawpaw. Oh, sorry about the noise. Should cut it up in there. Save the noisy bastard. Beautiful pawpaw. Loving the island food. Yeah. And if, when we're in an island, you know, there's pawpaw growing everywhere. You don't have to blend them. And they're so sweet and fresh, especially if you pick it off the tree. But here in Australia, we've got a good pawpaw farm. What do you call? From the shop. Okay, put that layer on it. Put the rest of the pawpaw on. Okay, that's two pawpaw. That's a one, half a taro. Okay, guys. Okay, again, little bit of pepper. Just a little powder. Little spread of salt. This is my way, guys. Do it your way. Okay. Squeeze off, no. Bit of lemon zest. This is the first lemon out of our garden. Our lemon tree. New lemon tree. Okay. Now add the rest of the coconut cream. Fingers crossed this will come out nice. Just like how the Niue is doing their Takihi, the Tiki, whatever they call it. I'm going to rinse up this, get a little bit of water in there. Yeah, keep it on the side so make sure it's running into the taro. That's it, guys. I'm just gonna fold it up, foil, and I'm gonna have to cook it on that in that tray. Okay. Oops, I just ripped that one. I just want to make sure that coconut cream doesn't come out. So you've got a lot of layer of foils. Usually we make this out in doing the umu, but you know I haven't got a umu outside, so hopefully that when this is ready and I'm open up, it'll look good. Fingers crossed. This is going in the oven, guys. Give it a little shake there, the coconut cream is running through that thing. Okay, and we're gonna put that leftover taro in our oven to go with the octopus. And this can go with octopus too, and meat and stuff. Okay. Hey guys, welcome back. I just put our Takihi now in the oven. And I put it in the middle shells and put it in a high heat until it's warm up, heat up. like 20 minutes and then turn it down in halfway. So we will need, I want our taro and our popo to cook really good at the same time. Okay, here's our octobush. It's come out of the oven. You see all that water? All that water's come out of the octobus. And our octobus now is less water in it. We'll cut it down and cut it up. Usually do it with an ink, and then that water, you see the ink go in that water. And you can dip it into the octobus. But we can't get octobus with ink in it. Here in Australia, you have to shop around to find the ink in the bags. Okay. Here's our octobus, and we're ready to cool it down and cut it up and into the coconut cream. I'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, welcome back. I've got a pot here. I was going to put our octopus in the oven, but I can't fit the octopus in there. I've got the taro and pawpaw in there, so I'm going to have to use the pot. Okay, it's great. Same thing, I rinse it up with water. I'm gonna have to cook that coconut cream until it's going down and then need the oil, bring the oil out, get the oil out of coconut cream. And then I'm adding 3 onions. So I like a lot of onion. Flame of the octopus. Just 3 of those whole cloves. Squash it up and put it in there. Don't have to cut it because it'll melt into the sauce anyway. Okay, bit of fresh ginger, not too much. It's a little bit to flavor our octopus. That's it, guys. Because if I put too much, it's going to need to keep seafood flavor in it. Okay, put a lid on it. When it comes to boil, turn it right down until cook it off until the oil is coming out of the coconut cream. Yeah. I'm going to cut our octopus. Look at that. I'm going to slice it small. Not too small. A big bit, yeah, cut it small. Now this, guys. Into the bowl. Beautiful. This is boiled, turn it down. That's it. And keep cutting the octopus. I like to leave those longer. Guys, yeah, the more you cook the octopus, the shrink. Yeah? Because it's still a lot of water in there. Too much. And very chewy. Oh, they took the finger. Good. Either cook it less or be chewy too. This is the head, just like calamari. All ready now to go in there once our sauce is simmered down until the oil's come out of the coconut. I'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, welcome back. I've got to tell you, the juice was on that pink juice from the octopus one on tray. I added in there because it's all the flavor from the octopus in the ocean. Okay, I'm gonna add a bit of just a veggie sauce. Vegetable soup is in a chicken jar. Get a pepper, guys. Okay, I'm gonna add one bay leaf. You really want that oil to come out of coconut cream. Smells so good already. Smells beautiful. I need to add another coconut cream, another carton, so I send my bun down the shop to get another carton because I didn't buy enough coconut. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Welcome back. I've got pieces of taro that left from the boil bowl, and I'm not going to throw them out. I'm going to slice it up and put it in there. By the time the coconut is picking up, it's cooked. It'll be nice through our octobush. Yeah, set it in there, and it'll cook and maybe melt through it. Close with the octopus anyway. See, the coconut's freaking up, but leave the lid off it and keep stirring it, you know, like every 2-3 minutes. Make sure it's not burning on the bottom, and let it fit. Okay guys, we're back. Hey guys, welcome back. This is our coconut cream for our octopus. And look how it's changing color, and it's really thick. See, the oil is starting to come out of our coconut cream. It's really thick. The pieces of taro I've cut in there, it's all disappeared. Our onion's all melting. Okay, our octopus, I'm gonna add our octopus now. See, it's still got better water. And by the time it's cooked, you know, by the time all the water is going in there, and still got better water left in the octopus, so I'm going to leave it on low. I already add another half of a coconut cream in there, and look how thick it is. And it's going to be watery again because our octopus, we added our octopus with better juice still in there. And I'm going to keep cooking on low. Once the water of all that octopus is gone, it's going to be freaking up again. So I keep cooking on the low with a lid off until our octopus is cooked, tender and soft, and yeah, beautiful. Okay guys, I'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, I'm cooking the quails. A little bit. And then it doesn't take long. Good guys. Won't take long at all. Marinated on a nice sauce. That's why it's browning. It's quite crunchy. No, it should be crunch. And I'm gonna fry it. I make this chicken drumstick. It's gonna be for the kids because the quail is gonna be spicy and plus a lot of bones in it. So, we'll work out, guys. Turn it over. This is very quick cook this quail. Really nice, really yummy.
give it 2 more minutes on the other side, and then I'll just put it on board. Yeah. Nice, nice, nice. Yum, yum, yum. Little quails, guys. Cooking very beautiful. We only want to half cook it. And I think it's cooked now because we've got to add it back in the sauce. Okay. Cook, guys. Put it back on the board. Okay. So we're going to add our little drumstick. The other two. Just going to fry it lightly. Guys, this is cooked. It's a little lollipops. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay. Gotta clean our oil out. Guys, fry pan's back on. A little bit of oil. And cooking oil. It's really windy out here. Now we're going to put got a sauce here I made in a blender. Chili, tincha, onions, sesame seed, fish sauce. So I'm just going to make a sauce. Everything, want to open. Sauce for quail, guys. What chili? Gonna cook that up. Rinse off that with a bit of oil. We got a spicy sauce. Anything in there? Lemongrass. Blend it together, chili, tincha, sesame seed oil, so the phone is going to fly up. Okay. Time to add our birds again. The quail. And the quails on the chili sauce. Okay, it's already fried. Deep fried, but now it's cooking again. Now oil. Oh, chili spicy sauce. Give it a couple of minutes and I'll be ready. Guys, I think that's ready. I'll get a serving tray. Okay, guys, I've got our tray. Serve it in there. Okay. Let's shut it all.
There you go, guys. Now, spicy quails.
Gotta love it. Beautiful.
Yeah. Guys, here our octopus. Our Fai'ai Fe'e. Here's our what do you call that? Our thing with pawpaw and taro. Here's our chicken drumstick, and there's our fried spicy quails. So we're done now, guys. It's time to sit down and eat some. And yeah, look at it. It works beautifully. Okay, let's eat some. Guys, I'm gonna serve a little bit of taro and pawpaw on my plate. Let's give this a try. Yeah. Taro and pawpaw. Look at the layers going, you know, between everything is coconut. Okay. Let's get some octopus. And some of that quail, spicy quail. Oops. There you go, guys. A plate of food and some chicken if you want. Oh, yes, you can. Oh, something on TV. Cheers, guys. See, that's so easy to cook, to make all this stuff. Yeah, I'll use this spoon. Okay, I'm going to taste this Niue. Taro and the pawpaw. I never had it before. Oh, yum. Now I know what they're talking about. The pawpaw is not even that sweet. And that taro goes through the pawpaw. What's it? That mosquito. Absolutely yummy. Really worth it making it. I can eat it every day just by itself. Yum. And I put my little, you know, thing in it, just a bit of pepper and lemon zest and a bit of salt. Yum. When I was making, I think, sweet pawpaw with taro. But now I had it. I'm having it. Oh my gosh. And the creaminess of the coconut cream going through it. Oh. Yum. Just melts in your mouth. I think I can have that for breakfast, dinner, and lunch. Yum. Thank you to my viewer. Thank you so much for requesting this. It is beautiful. And God. Yum. There's an octopus. Because really good with this taro and their pawpaw. Because of anything that kahihi Thank you, love, for requesting this. Mate, that's beautiful. We gotta stop eating that oil boy next hour. Mmm. Such a little gold octopus. A bit of ripping to our quail. A little bird. Yum. Don't overcook them. Oh yeah. Everything today goes together. The taro and the pawpaw and coconut cream. And the octopus and coconut cream, so a bit salty. And then a quail with spicy. Oh, this is heaven. The octopus. Mess in your mouth. You gotta really let the coconut, if you cook it in a pot, you gotta really keep your eye on it and keep the coconut cooking. With the onion. So you're fixing the oil start coming up on top. Then you add your octopus. But put the octopus in the oven first. Just on the dry bread, yummy. It turns red and you see all the water, most of the water come out of it. That way your coconut, when you put in a coconut, it's not easy to cut and it's not much water and watering your coconut. So I want some more of that taro thing. It's very juicy. See, if you overcook it, it's dry out very quick if you overcook it. Okay. Sorry to eat in front of you guys. Thank you for watching, guys. And I hope you're having a good weekend. And with families and friends, I'm sweating. And thank you for watching me and requesting. Thank you for your request to make this this food. If you need any more requests, I'm happy to try. Thank you. And I tell you what, it's beautiful. First time I try it. Just yum. Okay, guys. Love yous and leave yous. See you in the next video. Goodbye for now and God bless. Mwah. Cheers. Oops. Hey guys, the layer of that taro and coconut and and pawpaw, that is absolutely beautiful. The taste of it, yum. Okay, I've got a taro left over. I put it in there so I can give it to mom. And that's my quail. It's very juicy and yeah. And an octopus. Okay, thank you.